Let's finish up with, in case you missed it, and an old story resurfaced in recent days. Tim Donaghy, the disgraced NBA referee who was charged with conspiring to shave points for NBA games. Big ESPN story about this whole case and how it all went down. Tim Donaghy still maintains he did not fix games, but it seems pretty clear that he bet on NBA games and did some manipulating of calls to make sure the point spread went his way. What'd you make of this this ESPN investigation, and what do you think it means in terms of the credibility of the National Basketball Association?
Well, first of all, Tim Donaghy is a liar, because if you're a referee and you have the whistle, you control the flow. And if you're betting on games that you're officiating, then you're fixing games. You're doing what you need to do to get paid. That ESPN magazine report was riveting, Barry. It was amazing. It was like an episode of Goodfellas. I just thought it was some of the best work they've done in quite a long time. I think the fact that the New York Post got a hold of the story and ran it before the feds could mic up Donahey and expose some other refs probably saved this league, Barry, because imagine if five or six high profile refs were caught shaving points. Imagine the avalanche effect that would have had on David Stern and his precious league. Just as LeBron James is coming into his own and Dwayne Wade and guys like that, the league has never been in better shape than it is right now. But if they had not been just like a one-time thing with Donahue, if there had been like a half a dozen refs or even more, it would have been an epic collapse, and this league would have been pushed back 25, 30 years. All that work that Michael Jordan, Magic Johnson, and Larry Bird did would have been for naught.
Well, when you look at this whole story, the one thing I got out of the ESPN piece is just how many lowlifes, how many shadowy figures, some of them with ties to the organized crime, were involved with Tim Donaghy. And he relatively got a small amount of money compared to the big money that was floating around in this entire scam.
He had no idea how much power he wielded with that whistle. He could have made millions upon millions of dollars. He's getting a couple of grand. He could have bought his own island if he had been thinking bigger.
You know, and this goes back 100 years to the Black Sox, the White Sox scandal, 1919 World Series. You know, the players get paid relative pittance compared to some of the money going around. We go 90 years without another major scandal in terms of betting on the professional sports level. Do you think this cut into the credibility of not just the NBA, but professional sports?
Absolutely, Barry, because there are gamblers everywhere, doctors, lawyers. And are we really going to be that naive and assume that referees aren't gambling some way or another, indirectly? Maybe your wife has an account. It's out there. As long as there's a chance to get free money in America, there are people that are going to take that chance. So I know I always have an eye, I always have a side eye glance to some of these games when things start to happen that seem out of the ordinary. The cynic in me, Barry, always goes, I wonder if the fix is in. I just always have that radar about me. So nothing surprises me anymore. Donahey didn't surprise me. And what it probably did, Barry, is it probably put a lot of these refs on alert. And if any of them were involved in some nefarious activities, they cleaned it up. But you can't tell me there's a 100% citizenship rate in any professional sport. As long as there are people with financial problems, there's going to be someone that's willing to cut some corners.
Well, I'm not a cynic, and I tend to not believe in conspiracies. But when you read a story like this, it shakes that confidence. To me, the NBA, there's a couple things I assume they have done, I hope they are doing, and can continue to do. One is make it more financially viable for an NBA ref to keep his job. These guys are paid well. I think the average NBA referee salary, I believe, is $200,000. I think if you kick that up, make it even more advantageous for these guys to keep their jobs. They have less incentive to get involved in unscrupulous means. But also, the failure in this entire story to me is the NBA security for not IDing Tim Donaghy early on as a potential trouble figure. This was a guy clearly lacking in moral fiber, a guy with a lot of loose ends, a guy that was not a trustworthy fellow. The NBA security needs to be able to identify those guys early when they go to work for the league office. Hey, Cedric, it's been fun. We will do it again next week. Either Jenny or I will sit in with you for another episode of The Writer's Block.